Assalamu alaikum students, welcome to the very first lecture in real analysis. इस पूरे कोर्स में जो बुक हम फॉलो कर रहे होंगे वह है प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैथमेटिकल एनालिसिस बाय वाल्टर रूडेन। आज का लेक्चर एक इंट्रोडक्टरी लेक्चर होगा। सबसे पहले हम रियल एनालिसिस को डिफाइन करेंगे एंड देन वी विल ट्राई टू prove some theorems about rational numbers. जैसा कि आपको पता है continuity, convergence, differentiation और integration mathematical analysis के main concepts हैं and all these main concepts of mathematical analysis are based on an accurately defined number system. Hence, real analysis is concerned with the discussion of the main concepts of mathematical analysis based on the real numbers. तो real analysis को इस तरह define किया जा सकता है, so it is a branch of pure mathematics which deals with the study of main concepts of mathematical analysis like continuity, convergence differentiation and integration based on the real numbers. So, real analysis is the branch of pure mathematics which deals with the study of the main concepts of mathematical analysis like continuity, convergence, differentiation and integration based on the real numbers. सबसे पहले हम rational numbers की बात करते हैं. The set of rational numbers is not suitable for many purposes. So we will have an example in which we will see that there are some equations which cannot be solved in rational numbers. For example, there is no rational number p such that p square is equal to 2. So now we will prove that there is no rational number p such that p square is equal to 2. It means the solution of this equation is not possible for rational numbers. So we will prove it by the method of contradiction. So we will suppose that there is a rational number p which satisfies this equation. So suppose, so we suppose on opposite that P is a rational number. Suppose P is a rational number. So this implies P can be written as the ratio of two integers. So let's say P equals M over N, where M and N are both integers, N is non-zero, and M and N have no common factor. Okay, so here we have supposed on contrary that P is a rational number, so which implies P can be written as the ratio of two integers, and these two integers have no common factor. So this implies from the equation over here, P square is equal to 2. So P square will be equal to M square over N square is equal to 2. So this implies M square is equal to 2N square. As you can see that the number on the right hand side is a multiple of 2. So here the number 2N square is a multiple of 2, which implies it is an even number. So 2N square is an even number. So this implies M square is also an even number. So if M square is even, then this implies M is an even number. So if M is an even number, so this means it is divisible by 2. So this implies M is divisible by 2. So this implies M square is divisible by 4. So M square is divisible by 4. So if we see the equation over here, so here if M square is divisible by 4, so this implies 2N square is divisible by 4. So this implies 2N square is divisible by 4, which implies N square is divisible by 2, so which implies N square is even, so which implies N is also even. So here M is an even number and N is an even number. So from here we can see that both, so M and N being even number, so they will have a common factor of 2, which contradicts our supposition that M and N have no common factor. So this implies that there is no rational number P such that P square is equal to 2. So this means there is no rational number P which satisfies this equation. Hence, no rational number such that P square is equal to 2. Now we are going to prove another theorem about rational numbers. Let A be a set with all positive rationals P such that P square is less than 2 and be a set with all positive rationals P such that P square is greater than 2, then A contains no largest number and B contains no smallest number. So now, in order to prove this theorem, we will show that. So we have to show that so to prove this theorem we show that for every rational number P in A, there exists a rational number Q in A such that P is less than Q and for every rational number P in B, there exists a rational number Q in B such that Q is less than P. So we have to show this thing, that for every rational number P in A, there exists a rational number Q in A such that P is less than Q, and for every rational number P belonging to B, there exists a rational number Q in B such that Q is less than P. So this is what we have to prove. So we associate with each rational number P a number which is given by Q is equal to P minus P square minus 2 over P plus 2. So this is the number Q that we are going to associate with each rational number P, positive rational number P. Now let's simplify it further. So Q is equal to, by taking LCM over here, so we have, so P times P plus 2 minus P square minus 2. So Q is equal to P square plus 2P minus P square plus 2 over P plus 2, which is equal to, so here P square minus P square are cancelled. We have 2P plus 2 over P plus 2. So hence Q is equal to P minus square minus 2 over p plus 2, so which is equal to 2p plus 2 over p plus 2. So we associate with each positive rational number p this number q. Then q square minus 2 will be equal to, so q square is 2p plus 2 over p plus 2 whole squared minus 2, so which is equal to 2p plus 2 whole squared over p plus 2 whole squared minus 2, so which is equal to 4p squared plus 8p plus 4 minus 2 times p plus 2 whole squared over p plus 2 whole squared, which is equal to 4p squared plus 8p plus 4 minus, now first we expand the square and then multiply it by negative 2, so we get minus 2p squared and minus 8p and minus 8 over p plus 2 whole squared, so which is equal to 2p squared minus 4 over p plus 2 whole squared, so which is equal to 2 times p squared minus 2 over p plus 2 whole squared. Hence q squared minus 2 is equal to 2 times p square minus 2 over p plus 2 whole square. So q square minus 2 is equal to 2 times p square minus 2 over p plus 2 whole square. Now we will use these two equations. This is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. So now if P belongs to the set A, then P square is less than 2, which implies P square minus 2 is less than 0. So if P square minus 2 is less than 0 or negative, so here Q is equal to P minus. So if P square minus 2 is negative, then it will be equal to Q is equal to P plus some positive number, so which implies Q is greater than P. And also from this equation, from equation 2, if P square minus 2 is less than 0, so then this quantity is negative, so Q square minus 2 is less than 0, so which implies Q square is less than 2, so which implies Q also belongs to A. So here we have proved that if P belongs to A, then there is another positive rational number Q which belongs to A. Similarly, if a positive rational number P belongs to B, then P square is greater than 2, which implies P square minus 2 is greater than 0. So if P square minus 2 is greater than 0 over here, then Q square minus 2 will be positive, so which implies Q square minus 2 is greater than 0, which shows Q square is greater than 2, so which implies Q belongs to B. So again, for every P belonging to B, there is a Q which belongs to B. So we have proved the theorem. So from today's discussion, we have seen that the set of rational numbers is not suitable for many purposes. Although it is dense, that is, we can find a rational number between any two rational numbers, but it still has gaps. It is not complete, and these gaps are filled by real numbers. So the set of real numbers is a complete set. That is why it forms the basis of main concepts of mathematical analysis. Thanks for watching.